Well, you gotta be flipping my flapjacks. Look at this stock here, guys. This stock was up yesterday 23% in a day. Imagine you just happened to put a G in it yesterday, just a grand. I mean, you would have made $230 in one day. This stock has been beast mode. Check out the stock chart for this one over the past 7 months. Look at this, it is 10X'd. This stock has 10X'd in price in a matter of 7 months. That is absolutely ridiculous. And here today, the stock goes up again. Another nearly 6% move here today. The stock's now over $28 a share. You gotta be wondering, what in the world is this stock we're gonna talk about in this video here today, all right? Let's reveal the stock. Dun, 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 dun. Planet 30, I'm just kidding, not the planet, okay? NIO Limited. NIO, you guys remember this stock? This is a stock that when it came public way too early. Everybody was calling it the Tesla China, and they were still in like startup mode at that time. They had like non-existent revenues. They came to the public markets way too early. Let's just put it that way. A lot of people invested in this one on the IPO when it was like $13 a share. And next thing you know, the stock just absolutely tanked through the floor. A lot of people sold out, took massive losses in the stock. It was just an ugly, ugly situation. But this stock has completely come back to the life. Like I said, this is an EV player in China specifically. And you know, a lot of people like kind of the looks of their cars and some of the price points and things like that. So in this video, we're gonna talk about two things, okay? The first one is, what the heck is going on with NIO stock? Like, why and how did the stock go up 1,000+% in like 7 months? Because that is a ridiculous move. Like literally, if you bought this stock in March, April timeframe, which you had to have, you know, let's just say some guts to make a move like that, right? I mean, let's say you had put like $10,000 in the stock. You're now sitting on $100,000. You put $100,000 in it during that time period. You're now sitting on $1 million, and that's in 7 months. Absolutely insane. So we'll talk about that. And number two, and probably most importantly, is NIO stock a buy in my personal opinion? Is this a stock I'm interested in buying or not? Things like that. We'll get into all that in this video. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, if you don't mind, smash that thumbs up. That helps the YouTube channel out massively with the algorithm. I appreciate each and every one of you guys that are part of the thumbs up squad. Also, if you haven't got to check out Stock Hub yet, it's a free stock market investing Discord chat that we created. It's about to hit 1 week old as of, I think, around 6 or 7 p.m. Vegas time tonight. I think we're going to be around 18,000 members right around when we've hit, you know, basically 7 days in. That's absolutely insane. Alrighty guys, let's start getting into this. So what the heck is going on with NIO stock for it to go up like this? Well, first off, this company in that March, April timeframe, a lot of people thought this one was gonna go bankrupt, okay? They were gonna go to zero, essentially. I mean, Roni was going on. The business was just in a devastated place at that time. And the stock was, you know, $2.40, $2.60 during kind of that March to April timeframe. A lot of people thought this company was gonna go bankrupt. And I gotta say, for good reason, they thought this company was gonna go bankrupt, okay? Look at this. Their balance sheet, okay? Their cash and cash equivalents with short-term investments was all the way down to $973 million, okay? Meanwhile, this company had current debt, okay, of $1.2 billion, all right? That's current debt. Then you add on top of that, the company had long-term debt of $7.1 billion. Yes, people were in their right mind for thinking this company could go bankrupt. I mean, they had stockholder equity of negative $6.2 billion. Like, that's absolutely unbelievable. And it wasn't just that their current debt was massive and they didn't have nearly enough money to basically even pay the current debt. It was like, look at the company's losses. They had an operating loss, not an operating income, okay? An operating loss of over $11 billion this past year. That's insane. They had a net loss of $11.4 billion last year. So the company is losing money hand over fist. No other way to put it than that. And then you add on top of that, the world has to shut down and go into lockdown mode, okay? And yeah, a lot of people thought this stock was gonna go bankrupt. It makes sense for this fear that came into the market to push the stock all the way down to $2, because my goodness, guys, when you look at the losses this company was taking, the horrible balance sheet, the world shutting down, you know, a lot of people were you know, in the right to at least think the company was possibly going to face bankruptcy and go to zero. But then a bunch of lifelines came in for this company. Look at this. April 29th, EV startup NIO secures $1 billion investment from China entities, okay? And then look at this from September. NIO didn't just raise that time. They raised about $3.6 billion so far this year. They've raised massive amounts of money time and time again to the tune of about $3.6 billion. Look at this. As of September 3rd, NIO had raised about 25.4 billion yuan, which is $3.6 billion in primary and secondary markets. This does not include the 10.4 billion yuan of integrated credit, which is about, I think, a little under $1.5 billion of credit there. That's an extreme, okay? So a lot of people thought this stock might go bankrupt, and guess what? They didn't go bankrupt, and they secured a ton of financing. Then you add on top of that, this, okay? The numbers have been pretty amazing recently. Look at their latest quarterly results. These numbers are strong, okay? 2020 Q2 deliveries came in at over 10,000. That was versus the previous quarter of Q1, which was 3,800, and that was versus the previous year in the same quarter, Q2 of 2019, of 3,500. So you look at those delivery numbers, and they're flat out amazing, just flat out amazing. So you have the company raise a ton of money, and the company reports some blockbusters numbers if you're comparing it versus the previous quarter or the previous year. Absolutely amazing. Then you add the third piece on. This is why you get like a perfect storm around this NIO stock and how it pushed up 1,000% in 7 months. NIO soars to record after JP Morgan selects it as a long-term winner in China's EV market. The JP Morgan analyst led by Nick Lai, which let me say that's not the best last name for like a analysts, okay, upgraded NIO's ADRs to their equivalent of a buy with a price target of $40, nearly tripled from $14. The analysts are the most bullish on NIO out of the 15 analysts surveyed by FactSet, and their new price target represents an 85% upside from Tuesday's closing price for NIO. Look at this, okay? In China's smart EV market, we expect NIO to be a long-term winner in the premium space among Chinese brands, leading the mass market, while BYD should likely see strong EV demand with rising external battery sales from 2022, the JP Morgan analyst said in a note. Electric vehicle penetration in China is set to quadruple by 2025 to 20% from less than 5% in 2019, the analyst said. A production cost parity with internal combustion engine vehicles is seen by 2022 or 2023 as battery costs drop further, they said, okay? Big upgrade there, needless to say. And then today, as if Wall Street wasn't done like upgrading the stock, look at this, just today, NIO stock rises toward another record after Citigroup says buy, boost target by 83%. Shares of NIO hit another record, bucking the big sell-off in the broader market after Citigroup analyst Jeff Chung turned bullish on China-based electric vehicle company, citing a very strong order backlog, increased market share, lower battery costs, and policy tailwind related to exports. Chung raised his rating to buy after being at neutral since March and boosted his stock price target by 82.4% to $33.20 from $18.10. He says, quote, we estimate NIO's accumulated order backlog after deducting weekly shipments to have increased by 100% to 7,000 units between now and the end of September, implying 1.5 to 1.8 monthly level, Chung wrote in a note to analysts as well as clients. As such, we believe margin visibility has improved dramatically, all right? This is how you have a stock go up 1,000% in 7 months, okay? This is a perfect storm scenario. Have everybody think the company's going to go bankrupt. Then a flood of money comes in the stock to basically save the day so the company can make it through, okay? Then go ahead and post actually really impressive numbers and then have Wall Street come behind you like left and right. Like this is the perfect storm, literally the perfect storm to get a stock to go up 1,000% in 7 months span. unbelievable, okay? But what do I think about all this, all right? Well, first let's get into the good before we get into the bad, and then I'll give you kind of my full opinion if this is a stock I'm interested in buying, watching, short selling, anything like that, okay? The good. Almost all new car sales will be EVs in 2030 and beyond, in my personal opinion. And guess what? NIO is an EV maker in China specifically, which can arguably be the biggest market for EVs over the long term. And that is phenomenal, phenomenal news. You guys know I've said this many times on the channel over the past couple years that I just don't foresee, especially, I mean, even 5 years for me, it's hard to see this first scenario, but never mind 20, 30 and beyond. It's hard for me to see a human going to a car dealership and saying, hey, can you please give me one of those internal combustion engine cars? Like, no, okay, that's just not happening, okay? It's just not happening. I mean, literally in 5 years from now, it's almost impossible for me to foresee that. Never mind 10 years down the road. Like 90 to 99% plus of cars sold 10 years from now will be EVs. There's just no doubt in my mind. People aren't going and saying, I want an internal combustion car. Everybody's garages in the future will look like my garage, where they have EVs parked in, okay? If they even have cars, which keep in mind, with autonomous taxi networks, some folks might just decide not to even get cars or own cars themselves. I think there will always be a segment of the population that wants to own their own cars that they can drive anytime, but there will definitely be a huge segment of the population that won't even buy cars. But when those people get into those cars, I can almost bet you any money, they're gonna be electric vehicles, okay? Revenue estimates, look at this. 98, almost 100% growth expected in current year. That's amazing, okay? Especially when you just talk about like vehicle sales being awful this year for most companies out there. To post 100% growth would be insanely impressive. Let's just put it that way. Look at next year. They're expected to grow another nearly 80% next year. That's extremely strong growth, needless to say. That's unbelievable, okay? Then you have this. This is some more good news. Okay, look it. The numbers are getting closer and closer to break even. So basically, year ago, they lost $1.50. This year, they're expected to lose 72 cents per share. And then next year, they're expected to lose 47 cents per share. Those are still really big numbers in terms of losses, but they're getting better and better as long as, you know, things continue to progress. They should get closer and closer to break even, which is obviously a sign you want to see if it's a company you own. And then also, for the good, they have a ton of backers. Like, look at that. The company's raised $3.6 billion. That means there's a lot of companies and a lot of investment funds and investors in general that have NIO's back that want to see this company succeed over the long term. I mean, just countless backers, okay? And that's a very good sign, especially in a space like this with a company like this that's losing money, but ultimately having some really impressive numbers, all right? Now, let's get to the bad, because there's definitely some bad in relation to this stock, all right? Look at the net loss. This is for just their most recent quarter. We're not even looking at last year. We're looking for the most recent quarter they just reported a couple months ago, okay? Net loss came in at $166 million. So the losses are, you know, getting a little less, but it's still massive. I mean, that's still a lot of money to lose in a three-month span, especially when you put up some pretty impressive numbers. There's no doubt about that. That's tough, okay? But that's not the worst part, okay? The worst part, in my opinion, is kind of how I see the competitive landscape growing over the next 5 to 10 years in China specifically. Remember, NIO is going to be mainly a Chinese player. It doesn't mean they can't expand to more international markets, but I think the bread and butter of NIO's market long term will be China, and the competitive landscape is going to be, I think, ugly there, okay? You're gonna have a ton of players in China making vehicles at the low end and basically undercutting NIO's prices. That's what I foresee, okay? A lot of companies basically racing to the bottom and trying to create the cheapest EV, the most affordable EV, and trying to come in with, you know, price brackets of, let's say, 15,000, 20,000, 25,000. I see a lot of companies that will be in China that are gonna try to basically undercut a company like NIO, and I think there's gonna be a countless amount of them, okay? It doesn't mean those companies will win. I just think it's going to be extremely competitive price-wise. If you're not competing with, because you have a super strong brand, you're going to be competing on price, and you're going to try to undercut whoever you have to, which is obviously NIO in the situation. So if you're thinking about like competing at the, let's say, mid to low end, I think it's going to be probably the most competitive market for EVs in the entire world, in my opinion. I think it will be the most competitive in China, okay? But not just that. So you're getting cut from the low end is how I see things going. But also, if you're competing at the mid and the high end, you got to compete with Tesla. And Tesla is a no-joke competitor as far as a company you're competing with, essentially, okay? Remember, Tesla already has massive brand in China and massive supercharger expansion going in China right now. They're expanding superchargers everywhere. And those superchargers, that makes it a lot more convenient for customers to go ahead and buy your product, use your product, and it's phenomenal for branding as well. And that was just announced this past summer, a massive supercharger expansion, okay? Not just that, Tesla already has a massive amount of superchargers in China. Like if you go to Tesla's website and go to Tesla superchargers in China, like the list is crazy big, okay? Just what they have now. Look at this map here, okay? I mean, the amount of superchargers all around China, I don't think there's gonna be a company that can compete with the supercharger network in China. The same way, there's no one can even like, no one's even remotely competition in the United States because no one has the type of vehicles Tesla has, type of mileage, all those sorts of things, but also no one has the supercharger network that Tesla has in the United States. So no one can compete. It's just a huge moat around the business because it takes billions upon billions of dollars of investment in years of basically building out these supercharger networks, and Tesla has it in China, okay? Never mind the brand. And then as I've always said when it comes to Tesla, I think China could be a bigger market for Tesla than the US and EU, which means essentially if I believe that, there's a good chance Elon Musk also believes that, as well as the other executives at Tesla also believe that, okay? I think, you know, very much so, like China could be potentially the biggest market for Tesla. And if that's true, that means Tesla's gonna be as competitive in that market as any market in the world, if not more competitive over the next 5 to 10 years. Look at this, Tesla's China-based Model Y is gonna start at $41,000. You get ready for some numbers to be put up there. Remember, Tesla has an unbelievable brand, an unbelievable respect for their brand in China. Elon Musk's brand is actually really large. It's probably one of the biggest business legends from the US in China, if not the biggest. I can't really think of anybody off the top of my head that's respected as a business legend in China bigger than Elon Musk, okay? So, you know, this is gonna be a lot of competition. Look at this. This just came out about a day ago, right? Tesla cuts prices of Model S in the United States, but also guess where? China specifically, okay? Cutting the price of Model S so it gets even more competitive. I wouldn't want to compete with Tesla on the mid or the high value cars. Let's put it that way. That's tough. This guy right here, he's a very dangerous businessman, okay? If you're competition, he's a very, very dangerous businessman to be competing with, okay? And here's why. He's got the brand leadership. You can't touch his brand anywhere in the world, especially in China, okay? And it doesn't matter. Like any car you try to stack against a Tesla, Tesla's gonna win, just straight up. So he's got the brand leadership. He doesn't care about short-term profits. This is very big, okay? Doesn't care about short-term profits, and he's going after market share, which is why he goes ahead and cuts the price of the Model S. He's like, hey man, we don't need to make too much profit on that. Let's go after market share. Let's get more Teslas in more people's hands so they go ahead and tell friends and family how awesome Teslas are. That is dangerous. It reminds me of this guy. I don't remember his name, but I know he's really important. I think he might have been like, he's kind of like the richest person in the world. Like guy had a divorce, lost a bunch of money, and somehow he's still the richest man in the world. Like that guy's special, right? Brand leadership, caring about market share over short-term profitability, okay? So that's tough, okay? The competitive landscape's gonna get ugly, I think, over there in the next 5, 10 years. But then you look at this, NIO has a very rich valuation on it. It's not like it's a cheap company like it was, you know, some months back. It's got over a $34 billion market cap on this company right now. Over $34 billion. We're looking at a price to sales ratio on this company of about 30 right now. You know, that's, I mean, there's no other way to slice it. That's really, really dang high. I mean, a lot of people say Tesla stock's overvalued, right? Tesla stock's trading at a price to sales of 16. NIO's younger than Tesla, but Tesla also has way better technology than what NIO has. I mean, a lot of stuff NIO actually outsources, whereas Tesla's vertically integrated. They obviously have brand leadership in the EV space, the energy space. Like, I don't even think you should really compare the two companies. And Tesla comes in at, you know, almost a half of the price to sales ratio versus NIO, okay? So for me personally, I will not be buying NIO stock, but I will be watching NIO stock. I'm not gonna short sell the stock, heck no. And I'm also not gonna buy the stock. I'm just gonna watch NIO stock. I think it's pretty interesting. I love the growth NIO has. It's amazing growth, no doubt about it. I love that they're an EV player and an EV player in China. I love that they have big backers that have financial interest in China, in NIO succeeding. I think that is absolutely massive. I don't like the valuation, okay? And I don't like the competitive landscape specifically in China, but in EVs in general, but specifically in China, I think it's gonna be the most competitive market for EVs in the entire world. There's just no doubt in my mind. I think those players are gonna be cutthroat over there. I think it's gonna be tough, let's just put it that way, okay? And so ultimately, I will be watching NIO stock. I'm gonna keep track of this. I will keep it on my stock tracker app. And who knows, maybe someday I do buy this stock. But as of right now, at least, as of right now, it's not a stock I am interested in personally buying. And to anybody that has bought it or wants to buy it, I wish you all the best. And I hope you make a ton of money in this one. But for me, I would just rather be in Tesla stock. It just feels a lot safer and you still get massive growth over the next decade or two. So hope you guys enjoyed today's video. As always, if you don't mind, smash a thumbs up. Helps YouTube channel out in a massive, massive way with the algorithm. And I appreciate each and every one of you. Also, if you haven't got to check out Stock Hub yet, definitely do so. It'll be the pinned comment down there. It's also linked in the description. We have an EV section under the industries tab. So if you want to talk about NIO stock or the EV players, you can absolutely do it in there. And we also have a Tesla dedicated chat in the Stock Hub as well. So if you just want to talk about Tesla stock, we have that tab in there as well. Thank you for watching and have a great day.